Hi, I'm Mike from 3 Big Friends. Today I'm going to show you a quick tutorial on how we built the stained glass windows in our church, which is currently in our Christmas Winter Village mock. If you want to see update 6, click on the link on the screen. Okay, so this is the structure of the church. We've built it out of dark bluish grey bricks. The front wall is 3 bricks deep. We've done that on purpose so we can have an external brick wall with the glass sandwiched in between that and an internal glass panel. This may change in the future when we develop the insides of the church, but for the time being I wanted something behind the stained glass window to give it structure. So if we take that glass panel out, this is what it looks like. So that gives us our basic height. We know that it's just short of that height, and actually it's 4 bricks wide, not 6, but we will need to put in a little notches to hold it in, otherwise it will just fall forwards through the gap. So based on that structure, we can create a template form. So this is just done with bricks and plates. And as you can see, there's 2 open areas, one on the left, one on the right. They're the white panels that are above those trans-orange plates. Trans-orange plates are just there to remove the studs off those white plates on the bottom. They won't transfer across onto the stained glass window. So we have 2 identical forms. The stained glass is going to be identical, the openings are identical in the church. So we're going to build them together, side by side. And we're going to use primarily cheese slopes in trans-orange, trans-blue, trans-red, trans-yellow and trans-green. We've also got a few tiles and a few plates in yellow and blue and green and orange and clear. And we'll use them where we can. So first off, I sat down and came up with a few ideas. I knew what space I had, I knew what size each of the features needed to be, and there needed to be a central idea, and that was this star. So it's made up of trans orange and trans red slope pieces. You put 2 slope pieces back to back and you get a diamond shape. 6 of those make a great looking star. The good thing about these cheese slopes is they're, as with all Lego, uniform in shape. So you can actually put them back to back and put them side on, and over time you can make a mosaic type pattern, which is exactly what we're doing here. This is the second design, which will be used at the top of the star. And lastly, below the star is this design. It's some diamonds. These are just random patterns. But as you can see, there's no grip to anything. The 3 plates on the top are stuck together, the 3 plates on the bottom are stuck together upside down, but all those wedge plates are just laid down flat. So as you can see, as we start putting the pieces into the template, the structure around the side, the grey 1x2 bricks, hold it in place. Much easier than creating it loose on a board. And here we are, this is the 2 of them as I create side by side. Started on the left, transferring the design onto the right. That's the picture of both left and right completed up to the point of adding in the top design. And there it is, so that's the top design. Most of that top design won't actually be seen because of the arch of the window, so it shouldn't overpower too much with the orange and reds. And that's just a close-up of the star pattern with the yellow and the trans-clear bricks around it. Unfortunately, it doesn't come across very well on the camera, but it is alternating orange and red diamonds throughout the star. And that's the picture of it finished. That's me holding it up. It's nice and strong. I mean, you couldn't turn it upside down, but certainly it's not going anywhere. You can move it around. You're not in any fear of pieces sliding. So, okay, so the next problem is you've got to move it across from your template structure into the actual church window frame. And the best way to do that is to secure all those slopes together. And the way I did that was to run a strip of sellotape straight across the top of it. So one side is secured nicely. That will be the inside of the stained glass window in the church. But because I've done that, it means you can pick up the whole structure in your hand. It's all stuck nicely together and is movable and is effectively one piece. So the next problem to overcome is the fact that that 4 width of bricks is the same as the window frame. So what I've done is I've replaced the green 1x1 plates with 1x2 trans clear plates, and that allows it to stick out the full width of the 6 bricks across, which means it won't fall forward through the window frame, as you can see in this picture. So that's the windows in. I think they look pretty good. Certainly backlit, they look excellent. So we can put the church back in our Christmas Winter Village mock. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. I hope it's been useful. Please subscribe to our channel. Please check out our other videos for our Winter Village mock, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.